So I really don't know anything about the Lord of the Rings, but I do know a lot about tracking the wealth of the world's richest people. One of the newest billionaires is Peter Jackson. If you're a Lord of the Rings fan, you're likely familiar with the award-winning director and co-founder of Weta Digital, a New Zealand-based visual effects company. The shop was founded in 1993 to create special effects for Heavenly Creatures, Kate Winslet's big screen debut. The movie was written by Jackson and his partner Fran Walsh, and Jackson also directed the movie. After that movie, Weta went on to do effects for a few more movies in the late 90s, but it wasn't until The Lord of the Rings when both Jackson and Weta became known for their stunning visuals and special effects. The studio went on to do everything from Lady and the Tramp to Avatar to King Kong and even those crazy battle scenes in the last season of Game of Thrones. And while he did make a nice chunk of money from directing the Lord of the Rings movie, Jackson entered billionaire territory when it was announced that Unity, the video game software maker, was buying Weta Digital for $1.625 billion in cash and stock. This means that the company whose software is behind hit games like Pokemon Go and Among Us will acquire Weta's suite of visual effects tools and their underlying technology, plus 275 of the firm's engineers. Which is a great segue to another new billionaire, John Riccitiello, the CEO of Unity Software. The news of the Weta acquisition sent Unity shares soaring, making Riccitiello a new billionaire as well. He graduated from UC Berkeley and spent nearly two decades working for consumer product companies like Clorox, PepsiCo, and Sara Lee. He joined EA as president and COO in 1997, where he helped create hit games like Madden and FIFA. Riccitiello launched a private equity company in 2004, but returned to EA as CEO in 2007 before resigning in 2013. A year later, he took the helm of Unity and worked on integrating their products for Meta's Oculus. The company went public in September of last year, but interestingly enough, Unity has never been profitable. They lost $282 million last year on revenues of $772 million. However, they've had strong sales growth and shares have soared as more and more people come into the mobile gaming and virtual reality space. And in South Korea, we've got two new billionaires, the first to emerge from the crypto space. Song Chi-hyung is the founder and president of Dunamu. He graduated from Seoul National University, where he got a bachelor's in computer science and economics. Prior to founding Dunamu, Song worked at a management consulting firm, Danal, a local mobile payment company. It was there that he originally worked with Kim Hyoung-nyon, Executive Vice President of Dunamu, who's also a new billionaire. Kim also graduated from Seoul National University, where he studied agricultural economics. When Korea's internet infrastructure began booming in the late 90s, he withdrew from an MBA program to work in what was then the emerging field of tech. Dunamu was established in 2012, originally as a news aggregator. 5 years later, they launched Upbit, a cryptocurrency exchange. It now has more than 8 million users. The move that propelled them from millionaires to billionaires? HYBE, the agency behind the biggest band in the world, BTS, bought a 2.5% stake in the company for 500 billion won, which is about $400 million, valuing the crypto startup at $17 billion. And exciting news for K-pop fans, or maybe not, HYBE is working with Dunamu to create BTS NFTs, which are basically digital collectibles. That's all for now. I'm gonna go watch The Hobbit, I guess.